Attorneys here say the federal government must step up to reduce the strain on resources and processing procedures. Juliet Papa, 1010 Winds on First Avenue.
With this time 2:31, we go now to traffic and transit. Here's Greg Wright.
Well, good afternoon, Donna. You're getting the business on the belt in Brooklyn both ways. Eastbound Bell, Pennsylvania Avenue, crash in the left lane. The mess goes back towards Knapp Street. Westbound Bell, getting worse from Flatbush Avenue over to Crofty Avenue. We've had this crash there seemingly all afternoon, and it's still causing a headache. B3 eastbound near Metropolitan Avenue, left lane shut. Emergency repair work because a manhole cover went missing. So the slow go from the Prospect westbound bed, getting you back to the Brooklyn Bridge, and it's starting to fall apart all over Jersey. Garden State Parkway southbound near exit 148 in Bloomfield. You got a couple of lanes out now. Two right lanes shut with a car fire. The mess inching back towards exit 153. Northbound of Western Star, getting up towards 15W and Kearney, flipped over tractor trailers. Got the right lane out. The sooner you can aim for the northbound Eastern Spur, the better off you are going to be. If you're in a jam, call the Barnes Firm Traffic Tip Line at 844-JAM-1010. That's 844-JAM-1010. Traffic sponsored by the Barnes Firm. I'm Greg Rice on 1010 Wind.
I'm Attorney Rich Barnes. If you've been in a car crash, choosing the right firm is crucial to get the help you need and the best result possible.
And they'll be asking weather, 4-day forecast, and get the latest from meteorologist John Furyk.
We're turning into a pretty nice afternoon across the tri-state area. Sunshine, just a few clouds, a breeze. Top of down 83 in Midtown. Then tonight, partly mostly cloudy, should be pretty quiet, pretty nice for the Yankees game. There may be a shower along the coast towards daybreak. Most places again tonight are going to be dry down to 67, and clouds and sun for tomorrow. Breezy, we're up near 80, probably windy right along the coast. There's going to be a pop-up shower tomorrow, but a lot of the time's dry, and then clouds and sun for Thursday night up 83. Friday, sunny, warmer up to 88, and then the humidity creeps up as we head through the weekend. And now the allergy alert forecast, sponsored by EMC and Allergy Associates. Put your same-day appointment online today. Today's outlook is medium to high, with ragweed the predominant pollen. Right now, it's at the park, 82 with sunshine, going up to 83 in Midtown. Back to weather meteorologist John Fear, coming to us from weather station, 1010 Wind.
Get the downtime in no time at Ocean Edge Resort and Golf Club on Cape Cod. Book a family-friendly multi-bed villa within the Villages and experience the excitement of a resort with all of the comforts of home. Pool, golf, tennis anyone, OceanEdge.com. With due time at 2:33, now that President Biden has recovered from his bout with COVID, it's his wife's turn, unfortunately. Joe Biden now in isolation.
The spokeswoman says the First Lady started feeling cold-like symptoms last night and tested positive while on vacation in South Carolina. She's said to have mild COVID-19 symptoms and will start taking an antiviral while isolating for at least 5 days at the private home where she and the president have been staying. The White House says he tested negative for the virus this morning, but will wear a mask indoors for 10 days per CDC guidance. The president recovered from a rebound COVID-19 case earlier this month. Sagar Magani, Washington.
And President Biden is interrupting his South Carolina vacation today. He's back at the White House signing off on a major win of his presidency, the massive climate, health, and tax bill known as the Inflation Reduction Act. The measure aims to make prescription drugs and health insurance cheaper, lower energy costs while making it cleaner, and raise taxes on the wealthiest Americans while cutting the nation's deficit. The bill includes a $35 monthly cap on insulin for millions of Americans on Medicare, who could also see costs drop on other prescription meds once the program begins negotiating with drug makers. Also, lower Obamacare premiums will be extended for the 13 million Americans insured under that program. It is primary day in Wyoming, where longtime Congresswoman Liz Cheney is bracing for defeat. Her outspoken opposition to former President Donald Trump could end her congressional career.
Liz Cheney's voting record in Congress was almost always in line with President Trump. When it comes to issues, she is staunchly conservative, but because she voted to impeach the former president and vice chair of the January 6th committee, none of that seems to matter for many Republican voters in Wyoming who say she is a Democrat and not a true conservative.
She was going to pick up Democrats to be famous as one of that.
But her supporters here say if she falls tonight, it's not the last you'll hear of Liz Cheney.
Alex Stone, ABC News, Jackson, Wyoming.
Meanwhile, in Alaska,